this is the second performance. And it's an even better performance. She's performing very well. Literally, she is on fire. Yesterday, we know that the frog had offered to coach her or to guide her or to teach her and train her how to become a better and even maybe a very good singer. And the training began the next morning. It was raining, but still then he began her vocal training. The nightingale said, "But I can't sing in this weather." And the frog said, "Come, my dear, we'll sing together. Just put on your scarf and sash. Ku-o, ku-a, ko-ash, ko-ash." These are just silly words which Vikram Seth has put in so that it rhymes. Sash and ash. The difference is that a scarf is normally worn around the neck and a sash is worn across the shoulder. It's similar to what you would see maybe in a beauty pageant or a beauty contest. Most of you might be familiar with the Miss Coot contest. Hopefully this year we will also have it. What he is trying to say is that put on your costume or your dress as you are going to perform and let us begin the practice. The frog is also cleverly convincing her that a little rain doesn't matter. When you go on stage also, you will be putting on a scarf and a sash and you begin performing just as you would perform in front of a normal audience. So the frog and nightingale journeyed up and down the scale for 6 hours till she was shivering and her voice was hoarse and quivering. Now this is the musical scale, the do, re, mi, fa, so, la, ti, then do again. And normally musicians always practice their scales. Practice makes perfect. And they did it for 6 hours, which was too long. So at the end of it, she was shivering from the cold. Her voice was hoarse and dry, very sore, and she was quivering, shaking. Maybe this was the result of the training. Now pause and think for a while. Is this the proper advice of a good coach or a good trainer? No, I don't think so. She began to feel a little unwell. And though she was subdued and sleep deprived, in the night her throat revived. Revived means it became a little better. Let us look at the meaning of subdued. It means of a person, a very quiet and a reflective nature, or simply a very soft spoken person, someone who is not at all rough and aggressive, someone who is not loud. In this poem, the meaning of subdued is also given as a way of telling us that this nightingale is under the control of the frog. And the sumac tree was bowed with a breathless, titled crowd. Now, bowed means literally the tree would bend because of the weight. Here it means that the crowd was so much that the tree itself began to bend. It could not take the pressure. Now, Vikram Seth has cleverly put a play on words. He says, the title crowd consisted of the following. He gives us a list of the titled crowd, the VIPs. Owl is of course a bird, but here he means the Earl of Sandwich. Now this is a real person and a real title. Next, he says the Duke of Kent. What he means by Duke of Kent is actually the Duke of Kent. This is also a real person and a real title. At present, Prince Edward, who is a cousin of Queen Elizabeth II, is the Duke of Kent. Next is Lord and Lady of Trent. These are also actual titles and actual people in England. But here again, he has put a clever play on words by saying, my lord. My lord means my lord. and milady or my lady. And mallard is actually a small species or a small type of duck. So Martin Cardinal Mephisto, this is what he means. Martin for a bird as well as a bishop, cardinal for another type of bird, very playful bird, and Mephisto for the evil nature of the frog. When Vikram Seth talks about the Count of Monte Cristo, he is referring to the Count of Monte Cristo. Now this tells a story of betrayal. Count itself is again a species of water bird. Okay, the next line says, ladies with tiaras glittering, in the interval sat twittering. Tiara is that small crown, normally it's worn by royalty, but later on it got incorporated or began to be used in beauty pageants, and just like the Miss Court or Miss Manipur or Miss India or Miss Universe or Miss World, whatever. Let me explain the meaning of twittering first. Now Twitter nowadays has come to mean the famous or the very popular social media app, but it has other meanings also. Twitter or to tweet, the origin is the sound of a bird. Now it's a repeated sound, that means it repeats itself, similar to what Twitter as a social media app does. To tweet, and it gets retweeted and retweeted, finally in a matter of seconds it has, you know, spread. That's perhaps one of the popularities of Twitter, is that it spreads so quickly, repeatedly. It also means to talk in a very light but also high-pitched voice, and some of us might even say a very irritating and noisy nature, which is similar to students in the class when the teacher is not there, and sometimes even when the teacher is there. Now, when people meet, normally they talk, and most of the discussions will be very light-hearted or trivial or not serious. And when the frog was watching this, this was a joy that was both sweet and bitter, or bitter sweet. The previous night, he was too busy counting money. He didn't really notice how the audience reacted. He was concerned only with their money. This time, when he watched the reaction of the audience, he felt a joy both sweet and bitter. The sweet part is the happy part. He is happy because he is getting money, and the nightingale is also performing very well. She is becoming exactly what the frog wants her to become. The plan was to bring her up and then put her down suddenly. That will take place, and I will explain that later in the next classes. But his plan is coming into effect. The plan is working. But he is also bitter because he is jealous. And the nightingale has a talent which he will never have. And people appreciated the nightingale in a way they never appreciated him. You know, the thing about bitter and sweet is all about reality. Another way of understanding this, bittersweet, is, let us say, the result of a beauty contest. The next time when you watch the Miss Court, just close in on the faces. But what about the others who did not win? Are they really happy? This is the meaning of bittersweet. In poetry, there is a danger to oversimplify things. I don't want to do that. Let us look at the deeper meanings, because the poet would have put these words there for us to discover. That is the whole idea of poetry.